Hello there and welcome to today's video. I am Dan and today we take a look at Fallen Angel from Matrioshka Games. Fallen Angel blends melee and ranged combat in a fast-paced pixel action RPG with boss battles to spare. Battle angelic armies and ascend through weird and warped holy realms and claim vengeance. Sounds like fun? Then you know what to do. Grab your cup of your favorite drink. This is Sniff, by the way, on this one. Adjust your chair for optimal coziness and let's dive into this gameplay. All right, awake, arise, O weary, forever fallen. That is my motto for every Monday when I'm going to work. But all in all, welcome. If you are new to the channel, I say welcome, welcome. And if you're just here to check out this game before you thinking on buying it, I say welcome to you too. It's a good way. So let's try out this game and see what we can do. We can dodge and we can attack. I like that you can actually dash and change direction mid-dash. But so far the enemies aren't really attacking us, I can say. They are pretty kind and just casually running around here. Not doing much danger to us. But let's talk a little bit more about why are we here though. So, as Lucifer, you'll be throwing down with all the armies of heaven across a multitude of strange realms, they say. And Lucifer, of course, is God's favorite son. That got cast out of heaven for leading a rebellion, by the way. Let's see what else we can talk about. We will travel from crumbling ruins to lush green valleys to strange places. And we will meet flying angelic beasts of all shapes with wings, even with tentacles. So don't get too excited though. Too many eyeballs and of course without a rosy-cheeked harp-playing cherub in sight. Yeah, so it was good to fill out all that while the game loaded a little bit too long, but we can live with that, you know. We can jump, of course. We don't have a double jump though, so we can't really change direction mid jump like that. We can control our flight or jump, so that's good. So what awaits us next? Tiny little. We can break items, but it doesn't really seem at the moment those pillars don't give us any bonuses. It's like loot boxes with ammunition and other stuff. And we are still in Purgatory, my favorite place. Find waypoints scattered around the realm so in order to save the game. You can also fast travel. Yeah. Purgatory, the place to be with the sunset to the right you saw there. Great vacation place. 4 out of 5 from me. If you just can live with all these inhabitants that are casually just walking around like it's all-inclusive paid trip to the Canary Island. Here you could just trying out all, because you can see if you see when you attack he actually moves a little bit forward, so that could be a challenge if you are close to ledges, I would guess, and fight, because it seems like you can fall off right about any of these to the right. Down to the Purgatory we go again. Pretty interesting though that we are in Fallen Angel, if we are that, and we can die from falling. But yeah, we have health cores that can heal us, and I think we're gonna get a weapon soon to shoot people or demons and other things. And what awaits us around the next flight of stairs? Well, here we go. Here we can actually fight them. Oh, there you go. Did you see that? That is the dangers of being standing too close and doing an attack. You actually fall off the ledge. Luckily, there are no penalty for that in this game, so you can continue to hit these little tiny monsters. The game reminds me a little bit about how, what is called HyperLight Drifter, I think it's called, from, I think it came out around 2016 or something. That was the really, I tried it a little bit, but this is not my strongest card of games to play. I usually have a tendency to meet up with these bosses, but I'm pretty, it's Sunday, I'm pretty positive thinking I will beat the first boss no matter what. So let's see. No new enemies at the moment. These flying ones, and we will get what is good. Pixel art blood splatter from these. We get a weapon in slot 1 out of 3. Light, reliable, and pleasure to shoot. That is all I need to know about that one. But yeah, can we go down here? Of course, we can probably go down the stairs and die. But your weapon will automatically reload over time as long as you have enough ammo shots. You can also save up your ammo to use as currency later. Gotcha. So it's a little bit like Metro Exodus and the other ones. Totally different game type, but still. Currency, ammunition could be used as currency. But the red boxes are ammunition shards. And the other ones are health. And I hope we find some more good stuff as we progress. But how is your Sunday if you're watching this on your Sunday, dear viewer? No new enemies? Nope. We need some new ones. But it's a good warm up. And I will just casually destroy everything because in these type of games, if you can't destroy it, it could be hiding something. Don't know if the game has any hidden secrets or rooms, but we'll find out. Oh, look. That is one flying weird beast. Wouldn't want to see how it attacks, though. Oh, it just tackles me. And what is this? Ah, the angelic Squidward. Come here. Oh, he explodes and he shoots things. Yes, it does. But I can actually dash and change direction mid dash. That is so cool. I really like this one so far. The controls feels pretty solid, actually. It's nothing to nag about there. I'm playing it on a controller, of course. Otherwise, you would hear my clickety-clack keyboard all the time. So where are we going now in this elevator? I thought angels flew everywhere they wanted to go. At least they do in the TV show Lucifer. Me and my wife just started watching that one a couple of weeks ago because we are always late to TV shows. So season 4 currently running. And I'm guessing we're going to see some of the archangels that we have seen in the TV show. Not that they are related though, but they usually use their names like Azrael and Amadeel. And who was someone else? We'll eventually see. As I try to solve this crazy puzzle. It's not a puzzle. If it would be a puzzle, it would be different combinations. So let's see. Should be done pretty soon with this one. Ah! Angels travel by light. So I haven't seen so much of the character yet on the looks of it, but we go to the roof and get immediately attacked. Thank you for that one. And as you see, it's a room full of pillars and beasts. So we, and 1, 2, I think it's 4 boxes. Hello, Squidwards. Go away. It's more than 4 boxes of ammunition and health here. So this is bound to be a boss room as I focus on killing these. We will see a boss. My boss senses are tingling. So that's why I'm currently just stacking up with every ammunition and health I can find. So he can show himself eventually. Because I think distance is going to be a good thing. I haven't shot anything yet, so I mean, there. Have a deal. He looks like me, Mewtwo from Pokemon, though. And we, I must say, we look like the love child of Spawn and Deadpool. But really cool. So we're going to fight this one. And of course he has the balls of light and attack us with, and he has a dash attack, and it's a little tricky to shoot him though, but we can, ow, we will play it safe. We will shoot him, we will dash, and we will go behind the pillar. I'm guessing his attack there will eventually break the pillars. We could not shoot through that one. So find a new pillar, stay behind it. I know it's not the bravest way to do it, but it's gonna work, I can promise you. Ow. How rude. But we can also heal and remove ourselves from his dash and shoot him in the foot, because he is like Achilles. He has a tender heel. Maybe he's been demon running a lot. I don't know. Exercising as a demon. Where is he though? There you are. Any? Holy Seraph Abdiel. Oh, we will wear him down eventually. See? Now he kneels, and then we shoot him a little bit more and dash. Oh, and he tricked us pretty good. But we have a lot of health. We have 5 health and 11 in ammunition. So I will do this without attacking him with a sword once. It will work. Fool, you bring only despair and destruction. You will never regain paradise. We will see. It's anything can happen Sunday. And there he was. And sweet loot, ammo shard, health core. Nothing new there, no. Consumables, we got a new one. Grants infinite ammo for 5 seconds. That is a pretty cool one. But I'm guessing we're not gonna waste it on puny minions, by the way. That shouldn't be too fun. Okay. We saved, we are safe. Now we hit this one. Fallen wings. Oh, I clicked that one. But we got wings. Let's see. Cute little wings. Can't flap with them though. I thought angels couldn't flap, but we can glide. Ow, come on. But the graphics is really good. I mean, it's a pixel art game, and who doesn't love pixel art? It's always beautiful to watch, and you see all the movement below you when you move around. Makes you feel like you're... Let's shoot this one. I wonder why they aimed left there. Could be a hidden enemy. But yeah, platformers in a calmer kind of way, because this isn't relentless of enemies everywhere. It starts really chill. And this is another one where we fly over. Let's see what else we can dig up. The game is out on Steam, by the way. Came out on the 22nd of October. And it's around 15 euros. With 10% discount, actually 15.11. And welcome to my humble demon home, or fallen angel home. I don't know why we are here though. Kingdom Come Hotel, that is fantastic. Thank you so much, Peter.
My, quite the ominous fella, aren't you? I feel like I've seen you before. Somewhere. Oh well, just sign here and you can be on your way. Feel free to relax in the lobby when it suits you.
Oh, that was kind of him. Let's repay him by... okay, let's investigate. What are we really trying to do here? No, we can't break that door yet. I say yet because it feels like I will do it eventually. But it has full controller support, by the way. And we can actually have a shared split screen co-op if you find someone to play with. And we have a new enemy type, like little... I don't know what they are though. Would be fun to see what they are named. And they don't have any war cry, but they move as fast as I do. And he has changed attack. Become more redder, I think. Yeah, he shoots red balls. Red. That is dangerous. But yeah, it's... The game relies heavily on... Should I say based on the Bible? Sounds very weird. But they use like a beatdown of biblical proportions. So I mean... And we are traveling across heaven on strange realms, as I said before. So it's expect them to be pretty dog. Ow! Some enemies are a little bit interesting. And so far I can't say that my biggest enemy yet has been the environment, because who is that in the background though? Maybe it's a dev, maybe incorporated themselves. But yeah, continuing on, I have the feeling we will eventually see a new boss, and if we see a new boss we will say that this is the end. But I want to go over there. We can climb on ledges. I have a lot of health cores now, and I will probably be using them. It's a good background music, by the way. It's really chill, and these are insane to meet in the middle of the room, because and I can shoot them like that, and there are no one shot one kill as you can see, so it's a bad tactic. There we will probably die if we continue with. I would love a spinning attack there, like a heavenly spinning attack a la barbarian style whirlwind attack. But we are healed, we are good, and we are ready to party. And another elevator. And where do we end up though? That's a good question, but I can say that this is a boss room because that's a locked area, so I will end this here. Alright, that was Fallen Angel by Matrioshka Games. I am Dan, it's been a pleasure showing you this game. I hope you've seen enough to make a decision if you like to buy it or not, perhaps. And I do indie game reviews and indie gameplay videos and on my channel. So don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe if you've been enjoying this video. And until next time, stay safe and stay awesome.